This video is a pending part of chapter number 1, the plant life. Now we are going to discuss about the types of leaves. There are two types of leaves. Number 1 is a simple leaf and the second is the compound leaf. Simple leaf: a leaf with an undivided lamina, that is the lamina as a whole is known as the simple leaf. The bud present is found in the axil of the leaf. Mango, papaya and guava are the example of plants with simple leaf. And the second number is a compound leaf. A leaf with its lamina divided into several parts called leaflets is known as the compound leaf. The stalks of a compound leaf is called rachis. The buds present is found in the axil of the main rib and not in the leaflets. Neem, rose have a compound leaf. Now the next part is a arrangement of leaves. We know that the main function of leaf is to carry out photosynthesis. Therefore, they are arranged on the stem in a such a manner so as to receive the maximum amount of sunlight and air. This arrangement of leaves on the stem is called a phyllotaxy. Let's learn about the different types of leaf arrangement. Okay, the first number is a alternate. In an alternate arrangement, only one leaf arises from the node. No leaf is found just below or above another leaf. The leaf arising from the next node is in opposite direction to the previous leaf. Rose and China rose are the example of plant that have such arrangement, means alternate arrangement. Okay. The next point is a opposite arrangement. In this type of arrangement, two leaves grow from each node and are opposite to each other. Plants such as tulsi and jasmine have their leaves arrangement in this manner. And the third part is a horologe. Here, a set of leaves grow from the each node. These leaves are at the same leaf level and from the whorl. Now the next part is a modification of leaf. Leaves also get modified in shape and size to perform different functions for the plant. Modified leaves serve the functions of food storage and providing support and protection to the plants. Number one is a leaf tendrils. Some plants such as the pea plant have leaves modified into a tendrils. Tendrils are collide thread like structure that provide support to the weak stem for climbing. When the tendrils come in contact with an object, they coil around the object and provide support to the plant. The next part is a leaf spines. Some desert plants show leaf modification in the sum of spines. Leaves are reduced in the size and they become pointed and spiny. These structures are known as the spines. And the next is a leaf scale. Leaves in some plants are modified into scale leaf. for the purposes of storing food and water. They may be a thin and dry as the ginger or thick and fleshy as in the onion. Okay. Now, some other leaf modification. Number one is a pitcher plant and the second is a Venus flytrap. Now we discuss in a detail. Besides some leaf modified that you have studied so far, there are other modification of leaves that helps the plant capture food. Let's know more about the pitcher plant and the Venus flytrap. We already discussed about the pitcher plant and the Venus flytrap in the 5th standard. Okay, pitcher plant. A pitcher plant grows in an environment that is deficient in minerals such as a nitrogen. To fulfill its nutrition requirements, it traps, kills and digests insects. Venus flytrap. Venus flytrap is another insectivorous plant that has its leaves modified to capture the digest insects. The lamina is divided into the two parts with the edges of both parts having a long pointed hair. The midrib of the leaf act as a hinge. When an insect comes into contact with the leaf closes and insects get trapped inside. The digestive juices then digest the insects.